and heart has become the battlefield. Ruh, the spirit, because it has come from the spiritual world, the deputy of Almighty Allah, the real ruler, it has its own armies. Pious armies. And nafs has its own vicious armies. And both forces are fighting with each other in the battlefield of heart to capture the palace, to capture the center. In this particular situation, the Ruh, the king, sends a message to the opposition leader. Why are you fighting with me? Why don't you live in your own limits? Why don't you become cooperative with me so that we may, by working together, we may establish a peace and harmony in the country, country of body. We may establish a peaceful society. Why don't you cooperate with me? Sends a message through his prime minister, the intellect. Intellect, the prime minister, the chief advisor to the king, Ruh, goes to the opposition leader, the nafs, and has continuous meetings, a series of meetings with the opposition leader, the nafs, frequent meetings with the nafs. Nafs is a very attractive opposition leader, very attractive. Nafs has many attractions to offer. Many attractions to offer, because nafs belongs to this world and Ruh belongs to that world. Whatever Ruh can offer, that is in unseen, that cannot be visualized, that cannot be perceived, that cannot be easily conceived. Whatever Ruh, the king, offers, he offers and promises the things which at present are in unseen. And whatever the opposition leader, the nafs, offers, everything which he offers is readily available. So with these frequent meetings and sittings with the nafs, the prime minister and chief advisor of the king is also detracted. And the intellect is also deceived and falls a prey to nafs. And intellect is also influenced by nafs. When intellect, the prime minister, the head of the organizing departments, is captured by the nafs, is influenced by the nafs, is controlled by the nafs, is detracted from the right path, and becomes a friend of nafs, and starts deceiving the Ruh, the king, and becomes disloyal to the king. So, since that day, all secret agencies and working and government departments which were working under the Prime Minister, they also get a message from Prime Minister to support the nafs, not to support the Ruh. Because now the chief advisor is with the opposition leader. So all departments which were working under him will also support him. So one by one, are leaving the king, the roof, and gradually one by one all are going towards the side of nafs. And the roof, the king, is becoming isolated in this whole country. It is becoming isolated. A rebellion has taken place. A revolt has taken place. The roo has started crying and screaming. There is nobody to assist him. There is nobody to work with him. There's nobody to understand him. There's nobody to talk with him. There's nobody to work with him. The whole battlefield has gone to the opposition side. And since intellect is captured and influenced, so the center, capital seat, is also captured by the nafs. Heart also becomes under influence of nafs. When this whole incident takes place and the roo feels itself isolated in this world, then roo starts crying. And this is the point where Maulana Rumi starts. Bishnu azne chuhi kayat me kunad. Was judai ha shikayat me kunad. We will come to this part. We will start it. What Maulana Rumi has said. His first verse is, listen to Ruh, why is she crying? Maulana Rumi has not explained the whole story. He has just started from here. Listen to Ruh, why the Ruh is crying. I wanted to give you the background, to make you understand what is the language of Sufiya and Awliya. When the Ruh feels isolated in this world, she screams, she is screaming, she is crying. Now summarizing the whole thing, now I am summarizing the whole story in a bit different way, but the same thing. I want to give you the summary. All these senses of our, in our body, they are the workers of this government. All organs, the eyes are the workers, ears are workers, tongue is worker, is a worker, hands are the workers, belly, feet, sexual organs. All these organs of our body are the workers, and they have been entrusted with specific functions. They have been bestowed with specific functions. These are the functionaries of the government, functionaries. But the functionaries and workers can't work on their own. There should be some guardian on them. So guardian over these workers are the senses. Senses, the hawas, are the guardians of the organs.